Hi, this is Mama Shan with another tutorial for our Kick It Off series. And this tutorial is going to focus on type. And we're going to add some type to the image. The headline will be Kick It Off with the Crown. So over in your toolbar, select the type tool. This is this letter T, and make sure that it's set to the horizontal type tool. And when you do that, you can see there are options in the top options bar where you can quickly select the font family or style over here, and the point size, which is how small or large it is, and over here set the anti-aliasing method. Up here are the alignments of the text, and the color swatch sets the text color. There's also features for warping your type over here. And you can get more robust palettes up for type by clicking on this little menu icon in the top options bar, and that'll give you the paragraph and character palettes. I'm just going to close that for right now. There's two methods to initially set type. One method is called point type, and the other is called paragraph type. And here's the difference. When we just click and release in the document window and type something, and I'm just going to commit that. This is point type. With point type, you see this little baseline and the flashing cursor. And then to commit it, you click the checkbox up here, or you can hold down your control key on a PC, command key on a Macintosh, and hit your enter or return key simultaneously. So it would be control enter or command enter to commit the type, which means you don't see that baseline, which indicates you can edit individual letters or words, etc. When you create point type, it creates its own layer with a T on it, and it will name itself with the first few words of the type set for that particular layer. The text I-beam that you see here, say if I wanted to move this text right now, I could do that in one of two ways. I could either hold down my control key on a PC or command key on a Macintosh, and it will toggle to the move tool, and then I can move it around. Or I can select the move tool and then move it around. The reason I mention this is a lot of times when you have the type tool selected and you go to try to move it with the text I-beam showing, if I were to click right now and drag, it's going to create actually paragraph type. And it's not going to move that previous layer. It's just going to create another layer here, and it's waiting for you to type something in. And this is something else that you should be aware of. If your layers palette has a lot of type layers that just have a default layer name, they're empty type layers and you should delete them. So I'm going to just, what I want to do is, the control enter this, I'm dividing up my headline into separate layers so that I have more editability freedom with staggering them and changing the fonts, etc. If I put it all on one line, Kick It with the Crown, it will look kind of boring. So I'm going to try to liven this up by creating contrast later on in the tutorial by varying the size and even the fonts for this headline. So notice now over here in the layers palette, it has added the word. So we know this isn't an empty type layer here. It is also paragraph type. Now, let me come back over here, and if I just click with my type tool selected on this layer, you'll see the bounding box for this type layer. And if I were to type some more text in here, and notice how it just floats down to the bottom. It will go to a new line with paragraph text. And I can change how this is aligned or floating by changing the size of the box by clicking a corner handle. If I did not want a return for that crown to go to the next line, I'd just stretch out my box here. normally when we're setting headline text, you're just going to want to use point type. Occasionally you'll use paragraph type. But if you want to convert one to the other, you can also do that. And if you go under the layer menu here, there's a sub menu called type. And in here, it says right now convert to point text, and that is grayed out. You can convert your paragraph to point text or vice versa, but what you have to do is first commit it. So we'll either hit Control Enter on a PC, Command Return on a Macintosh, or click the commit check mark up here. Once it's committed and highlighted, you can go up to the layer menu, back to the type submenu, and now you can see this is available. So I can convert this to point text. So now when I click on it, I know it's point text because it has the baseline and the flashing I-beam with it. Conversely, if I wanted to change the Kick-It to paragraph text, I can just click on this layer, just highlight it, don't double click on it or anything. It is selected, and when I go to layer into the type submenu, I can choose to convert it to paragraph text. And nothing changes that you can see. It will only change when you go to edit it by clicking the type I-beam in there. And now you can see this is paragraph text. So if I change the size of this box, it would automatically float some of this stuff onto the new line. I'm going to commit that, and I'm going to convert it back to point. Some other options with text up here that you need to be aware of, especially, is the anti-aliasing methods that you can choose. Now, looking at this at 25%, it looks okay, but I'm going to zoom in on this and show you what none actually looks like. I'm going to go in at least 100%. And I don't know if the video is going to show this or not. I think it will. But around the areas that have curves or diagonal lines, you'll see this stair-stepping going on. And that is called aliasing. We want to anti-alias that, which means we want to put a smoothing algorithm on the type so that it doesn't look jaggy. The only time that you would use an option of none on type up here would be if your type size in Photoshop was very small, like a 4-point type or 6-point type, and at that small size, turning off anti-aliasing actually makes the type more readable at very tiny sizes. But for regular type sizes, 8 and above, 8 points and above, the smoothing algorithms make it better. And I'm going to choose one. I'll show them all to you. I'll select Sharp, and we've still got some anti-aliasing. And here's the trick too. I need to be looking at that at 100%. Now I can make the type size larger for this so that we can really see it. Let me double click on the T. There we go. So that it's highlighted, and I'll change it to 60. And then commit that. And now we'll change the aliasing. I'm going to try crisp and see how that smooths up that area. Let me move this over here. And I'll try strong. Makes it a little thicker and smooth. And for this point size, I think I'm going to go with the smooth algorithm. So let's look at what it looked like with none. And you can see it's particularly on the H that has this curve, that putting anti-aliasing on there definitely smooths it up. And so I need to do that with my Kick-It layer. Change that to smooth. and commit that. You can also create a new type layer by duplicating an existing type layer. So I'm going to highlight the upper type layer and press Control J on a PC, Command J on a Macintosh, and notice it says with the crown copy. Now I'm going to hold down the Control key on a PC, Command key on a Macintosh to toggle the Move tool so I can just separate this for a minute. And what I'm going to do is double click on it, and I'm going to type the. And I'm going to edit the bottom layer because we've got a stutter happening in here with crowned. So what I'm going to do is double click on this, and I'm just going to delete all of this, commit it, come back up to the top layer. I'll duplicate that again. Control J on a PC, Command J on a Macintosh. Hold down the Command key to toggle the Move tool, and just double click on that T to highlight it so I can change the word. Okay. And now I'm going to work with changing the font families and the size to try and get this up to snuff. And notice when I did apply these, this is a sticky setting up here. Once you set that aliasing and your point size and your type, that's what's going to happen. So I'm going to come down here and just move these around to kind of get it to how I want it to look. I want to stagger, so I'm highlighting this stuff. All right. I'm going to come down here to where it says Kick It. Now to change the font size, which is what I'm going to do, you can come in here and select a point size. It stops at 72. So if you wanted something larger than 72, you can do that one of two ways. You can just type a larger point size, and a point is actually equal to 1/72 of an inch. Not that you need to know that, but that's how the measurement is for it. So say I wanted something larger for this particular word than one of the presets, I could simply type something in. I could type in 85. You can even do decimals. I could do 85.5 points and hit enter, and that would make it larger. I could also, let me get another type layer here. I could also just highlight the type layer that I wanted and do a Control T on a PC or Command T on a Macintosh, so that we get the free transform bounding box, and I can scale it. So I can, if I want to do this proportionately by dragging, hold the Shift key down and grab any corner handle. And this part is very important. If you want to keep the letter forms proportionate, hold Shift and grab a corner handle to scale in or out. Now, if you want to change the horizontal scale or vertical scale, you can do that quite easily by just dragging a middle handle either on the X or Y axis. So if we wanted to vertically scale this, we can drag it this way or this way. It's no longer proportionate. Or horizontally, we could do it this way. I'm going to hit the Cancel key, and when I do that, it will not commit the type. Now, I'm going to try to give contrast to this and a little more interest by introducing a couple of different font families here. And you can highlight your type layer that you want to affect and come up here and select a font You don't have to have the type highlighted to do that, but you can also go in here, you know, scroll down, look at your types. There'll be examples of what the font looks like. But if you want to cycle the font menu, just highlight this field up here, or you can do the font family window in here, just highlight it, and use your up or down arrow keys, and that will quickly go to some different fonts for you. And I think I'm going to choose Scriptina for this font. And if I want to make this a little bit larger, I can come under here, do something like that. I'm going to work on Crown right now. Let me move that out of the way. I'm going to move this. Highlight the crown layer. And let's see if I can find another font that I may want for this. Again, you just need to highlight the layer. And if you have your type tool selected, you don't need to double click on this. You don't need to have a highlight around the text to change it. Just so long as it is highlighted here and the type tool is selected, when you go into these areas here, and I'm going to use the up arrow to just cycle these fonts. Sometimes they may get stuck on certain font families, and you'll see that if you don't see it changing, and you'll have to get it unstuck by going in here and selecting something that you want, and then continue cycling by using your arrow keys. I think I'm going to go with what's called Bickham Script for this one. And I'm going to make this a little bit larger. Let's see what 72 does. I want it a little bit larger than that. So again, you can type in an amount or use your transformation key. Want it about that big. And now we'll go work on the. I think I want the to look like a little bit of a crown over here on the top. Click in here. I want the to be all caps. Now I could go back and just type all caps, but there also is some options over here when you click this menu to open up your paragraph and character palettes. Highlight the character tab. Let me move this over here. And click the flyout tab, and you can add all caps or small caps here. Let's see what small caps looks like. Let's see what all caps looks like. I think I'm going to go with the small caps. Now, one thing worth mentioning with regard to type is that depending on which layer you're highlighted on, if you wanted to click a new type layer, say for example, I click on the here, and my type tool here, and click to start a new line of type. If you're too close to another text line, it's going to jump to that. So be aware of that. If you see that underline, that baseline, and flashing cursor on an existing line, then hit cancel and then try to move your cursor to set your type away from that area. So I'm going to click back on the and click down here. And you can tell by the name layer 1 that it's waiting for you to type something in. But what this is going to do is actually take on the attributes, the font attributes of the previous layer, the. So if I type in something here and I'm just using lowercase, it's coming up in small caps because of that previous layer's attribute. So what you can do is be aware of that, commit it, but then come back into the character palette here, if you did not want small caps, and uncheck it, and it will go back to the way you typed it in. Another way that you can reset all attributes, you can come down here to reset character in the flyout tab of the character palette. That's going to change the font to your default font on your system, and mine is Myriad Pro. So that's something to basically work to uncheck these special areas here. We're going to cover some more nuances of the character palette and the alignments in the next video.